Lucille Nobel-Prize in Physiology or Medicine is awarded for discoveries concerning autophagy. The word autophagy is derived from the Greek language and means self-eating, to eat oneself. In the mythology of many ancient human cultures, the self-eating dragon is a symbol of self-reliance and renewal. In the human body, self-eating, autophagy, is a process by which our cells reduce their own components to release energy and to build new functional parts. Autophagy was first observed in the 1960s, soon after the discovery of the lysosome, an organelle that contains the enzymes used by the cells to disassemble proteins, sugars, and lipids into their usable building blocks. In addition to the lysosome, scientists observed another quite different type of organelle composed of a double membrane surrounding some cytoplasmic material. They also observed that vesicles appear in the cytoplasm of cells under stress, such as during starvation. The vesicles extended into double membrane that progressively engulfed a portion of the cytoplasm, forming what became known as an autophagosome. The autophagosome later fused with a lysosome, where the content was broken down by lysosomal enzymes. During the next 30 years, little more became known about autophagy. The mechanism for the process and the significance of autophagy for physiology or disease remained a mystery. The situation started to change in the 1990s when Yoshinori Ozumi decided to start the process of autophagy in Baker's yeast. Yeast cells contain a single large lysosome known as the vacuole. Ozumi found a clever way to visualize the accumulation of autophagosomes in the vacuole by making starved cells unable to degrade the content of the vacuole. He then used this method to search among thousands of mutants for yeast cells that had lost the capacity to activate autophagy. This ingenious strategy led to the discovery that autophagy is regulated by a large number of genes. As many as 15 essential autophagy genes were identified in the first study published in 1993. Having discovered the autophagy genes, Ozumi moved on to the next question, that was to understand how the products of the genes work together. Thanks to this pioneering work, we have today a detailed understanding of the molecular mechanism of autophagy. Ozumi showed that stress signals initiate a cascade of events that through the formation of different protein complexes control each step in the formation of the autophagosome, from the initial fusion of vesicles to the extension and bending of the membranes at the sequestered cargo, and finally to the fusion of the autophagosome with the lysosome. Ozumi and his colleagues were also the first to identify genes that control autophagy in mammalian cells. This allowed the production of research tools that have transformed autophagy into one of the most intensely studied topics of biomedical research. Thanks to the work of Yoshinori Ozumi and many others that followed in his footsteps, we now know that autophagy regulates important physiological function of the cells, and that defects of autophagy are associated with many human diseases. For example, autophagy is required for cell differentiation that gives rise to the many different types of cells that constitute our body. By recycling part of the cellular content, autophagy allows our body to cope with starvation and with other types of stress. By capturing invading viruses and bacteria, autophagy is essential for the body defense against infection. Through the removal of damaged proteins and organelles, autophagy promotes cell renewal. Failure of autophagy is therefore associated with cell aging and with many diseases of old age, such as Alzheimer's disease and type 2 diabetes. Finally, too much autophagy may have undesired effects. For example, in cancer, where autophagy can promote the growth of tumor cells and the resistance to anti-cancer drugs. The discoveries made by Yoshinori Ohsumi have been instrumental in revealing the mechanism and significance of a fundamental physiological process. And there is growing hope that this knowledge will lead to the development of new strategies for the treatment of many human diseases.
Thank you very much. So before opening up for questions, I would just like to introduce, in addition to Mariam Asuchi, Professor Nils-Göran Larsson, and Professor Anna Vedel, who's also the chair of the Nobel Committee, and they are here assisting to answer questions. So with that, I open up for questions about this year's Nobel Prize. So,
did you speak to the professor already?
Yes, I did. I was in touch with Professor Ohsumi this morning, right after the decision was made.
What was his reaction?
He seemed surprised. The first thing he said was, ah. I think he was actually not maybe expecting this, and he was surprised but very pleased, and asked if he was allowed to leave the building. And of course I explained that he would expect a lot of phone calls, and I think he was very, very pleased. So it was very nice to talk to him.
What is the price summit this year?
It is 8 million Swedish kronor. Any more questions? Here we have a question.
This is Janice from People's Daily Online. We are very happy that this year there is another Asian Nobel laureate, because last year was the Chinese Hu Youyou, also got the Nobel laureate. So my question is, what's your comments on the research improvement in Asia in the medicine area?
Yes, I think, of course, the Nobel Prize is an international prize and takes no consideration to where anyone is from. And I think it is apparent to anyone in science that Asian science is growing enormously, not least, of course, in China. So I think maybe we're seeing the beginning of this. We should remember that the prize we're awarding today were for discoveries that were done in the 90s. So I think we can expect much more to come.
So it's going to be an Asian Nobel laureate next time also?
not even we know about that.
Thank you.
My name is Annika Osman from the Swedish radio company. What about, is it Parkinson or cancer, or where do you think it is the most important contribution for the medicine?
I think I'll let Anna Vedel answer that question.
Okay, so can you hear me? Yes? So this is a prize for basic discoveries, but it's all very clear that autophagy is critically involved both in the origin of disease and in our way of handling, counteracting diseases. And this applies to a broad range diseases such as cancer, neurodegenerative, Alzheimer's, chorea, inflammatory diseases, diabetes. But exactly how this works in the different disease areas, that is what has been possible to study. So we have enabled totally new research areas that are now very active in addressing these questions. Neurodegeneration definitely is an active area, as is cancer. But the prizes for the basic knowledge and mechanisms and tools allowing these further research now, lines that are now exploding. So we can only hope for a broad impact in various diseases.
Okay, thank you. More questions? Here is one question.
In terms of applications, are there any concrete trials going on with drugs that are interfering with this issue?
There are lots and lots of activities of attempts to both stimulate and counteract the pathology. And it's a very complex biology, but there's a lot of activities. And the specific ways of really, really tailoring treatment is, we're not really there yet, but it's really ongoing. Many, many clinical trials.
But no drugs on the market yet.
Well, there are drugs that affect autophagy and also drugs where we didn't really know the mechanism and still don't, but they somehow affect autophagy, but not specifically work. We don't really have those drugs yet.
Maybe one can mention that most of the trials ongoing right now are for cancer. Did we see anyone more who wanted to ask anything? I know there are many eager for interviews are welcome afterwards. So I think we can then probably conclude this press conference. Thanks so much for coming to Nobel Forum today. Thank you.